I extend a very hearty welcome to every one of you for today's session. Friends, now you know we are understanding Dr. Wohl, which you know by understanding we can heal any disease. And who is the conveyor of this knowledge? Who is the conductor? Who is the teacher? Who is the guru or Sadguru? These guru, through their words and actions, not only words, even by actions, they transmit to the masses, common man, valuable hidden knowledge, thus making their birth worthwhile through their noble deed. These Sadgurus or transmitters leave behind invaluable inheritance or heritage for future generations. And I'm really proud that we are blessed to have our Samstan Professor Mrs. Chanchal Agarwal ji with us to, you know, transmit the hidden knowledge or, you know, what undisclosed hitherto. I mean, it is there, but, you know, we could not understand it thoroughly. She is the person who made it, you know, who communicated from the books to brain. So I'm very proud of her and extend a very hearty welcome on today's program on behalf of every one of you and on my personal behalf. So I don't want to take much of your time. Over to Professor Chanchal ji for today's session. Thank you, friends, and thank you, madam. You're welcome.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Ishan, and thank you, every one of you, for joining this session. Today, we'll start with the next meridian of Dr. Wohl, and it is fat degeneration meridian. So, the next meridian which we are talking about is fat degeneration vessel, fat demeridian, or we also call it fat tissue meridian. This is a very interesting meridian. There are many reasons for which I'm saying it's a very interesting meridian. First and foremost is whenever there's a word fat degeneration or fat related meridian, then we are always eager to know more about it because it would be treating the fat of the body, isn't it? So everyone is interested in somehow reducing the fat of the body, but no one is interested in understanding why that fat is getting accumulated in the body. So sab dawa mein bade interested hain. लेकिन दवा के पीछे जो कारण है बीमारी का उसको भी आज समझेंगे सो दैट वी अंडरस्टैंड कि व्हाई दिस फैट इज गेटिंग एक्युमुलेटेड एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम रिड्यूसिंग द फैट ऑफ द बॉडी व्हाट अदर फंक्शंस व्हाट अदर डिजीजेस दिस मेरिडियन इज परफॉर्मिंग सो दैट वी कैन यूज इट फॉर मेनी अदर एलिमेंट्स एज वेल ओके सो बिफोर वी अंडरस्टैंड दिस मेरिडियन फर्स्ट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट दिस फैट इज व्हाट इज फैट and how this fat is related to fat degeneration meridian. So we understand that there are three major components of food, right? All of us know that there are three. If we talk about food, then food can be divided into three main components, that is called the major components of food. Okay, so the major components or macronutrients. Macro nutrients, NUTRIENTS, macronutrients of food. So the three major part of food are protein, fat, and carbohydrate. Right? This is a basic idea. This is a very, very basic concept which everyone should know and everyone of us know as well, that protein, fat and carbohydrate are part of food. What is this protein doing? Protein is building up the body, building the body. So wherever there is growth, there is construction work, it's like the bricks. So it is the material which is making up the body. Wherever you need the healing process, wherever you need the growth of some substance in the body, you need protein, right? Fat is energy reserve for future use. Energy reserve for future, as well as at places it constructs the body where there needs rigidity. Okay, जहां पर भी rigidity की जरूरत है, जहां पर walls बनेगी वहां पर भी fat का use होता है. So construction में भी use होगा. Also in construction, carbohydrate is instant energy. It's a source of instant energy. So if you are in a marathon or you are performing something, an activity where your body energy is needed, then what do you drink? For instant energy, you drink glucose. Example, glucose. Fine. So fat is a reservoir body that is needed. It is not something which is not needed by the body. So उसको भी respect करना है, fat को भी respect करना है. Because अगर fat नहीं होगा, then how will we survive? Because fat is the barrier between the external environment and the internal environment. If fat is not there, then what is going to protect you from temperature, severe temperature changes or energy changes in the body? So fat is very much needed as a part of the body. So first and foremost, we should look at this fat with a lot of respect. But see, what is the definition of disease? Disease ki definition hi bolti hai kahin par bhi kisi bhi paristhiti ki kisi bhi avastha ki ati is disease. Excess of anything is disease. So fat is also, if it is an excess condition, if it gets deposited in a condition or in an area where it is not needed, then it is creating problem. Otherwise, it is very much, very important part of body, very important part of organ, very important part of tissue system, very important part of each and every cell. Every cell has some component of it, which is fat. Even the, I'll show you the pictures where brain has 60% fat. Yadi brain mein wo 60% fat nahi hota, then we wouldn't have survived. That is needed by the brain. Okay, so this is fat. But if there is any degeneration in this fatty component of food, then we call it fat degeneration. Then it becomes fat degeneration. And we have a meridian in EAV to treat this fat degeneration, and we call it fat D means degeneration, fat D meridian or vessel. Okay, so as we started, when we started EAV, we discussed that there are 9 tissue meridians apart from 12+2 PCA meridians, which are re-explained by Dr. Wall. So in these 9 tissue meridians, there are 4 tissue meridians which are in the palm, 4 tissue meridians which are on the foot, and 1 tissue meridian which is around the eye, right? So this is the 4th tissue meridian which is on the foot. So if this is foot, then what are the different tissue meridians which we have already covered? We have already covered, which meridian is this? JD. We have covered this meridian. Which meridian is this? On the third toe. Fibroid. Which meridian is this? Skin. Which meridian is this? This is the next meridian which we are going to cover today, and this is fat D. So we are interested in this meridian today. Okay, then we are done with all the 8 tissue meridians which are on the foot and the palm. right? Now, what is this fat degeneration meridian going to treat, going to heal? So understand it in two parts. One is fat degeneration meridian can be used to treat, it treats organs. It treats organs. And also, it treats tissue system. It's a very small meridian, very beautiful meridian to be used for treating different ailments. Very, very simple meridian. Okay. So understand that there are two ways in which we can use this fat D meridian. One is on the organs and second is on the tissue system. Okay. So what are the different organs that can be treated through fat D meridian? It's not, we are not talking about the whole body fat. We are talking about the different organs of fat. So one is, see, divide again body into three parts, right? In EAV, we talk always about three parts. One, two, and three. Three parts. So in the lower part, one major organ which it can treat is liver. So liver, okay. Another organ which it can treat, kidney. In the second area, it can treat heart and brain, liver, kidney, heart, and brain. Fine. Let us take one organ at a time, then we'll move on to the tissue system. Fine. So, liver. In the liver, what can be the fatty change? And all of you know that fatty change in the liver is called, if we are talking about liver fat, then the ailment is, because 60% of the people suffer from this problem, fatty liver. Okay. Fatty liver is a very, very common problem. In previous class also, we discussed about fatty liver in brief, where we saw that the fibrotic changes in the fatty liver may lead to cirrhosis, isn't it? So today we'll see only about fatty liver, what this fatty liver is. Fatty liver is also, it has also a medical terminology. In general term, in layman's language, we call it fatty liver. But in medical terminology, this is also known as hepatic, H-E-P-A-T-I-C. Write down in the book itself. If you have the book, we are following treatise 3. Okay, so in treatise 3, it is the fat degeneration vessel chapter. In my book, it is page number 78. You can just refer to the index. So in that book only, you can write down wherever it is written fatty liver. It treats fatty liver. You write down. It is also called hepatic steasis, S-T-E-A, steatosis. T-O-S-I-S, steatosis. This is a medical term for fatty liver. Okay, so what is this fatty liver? Fatty liver means there is always a fatty deposition in the liver. That is natural. But if there is excess of fat deposition in the liver, for some reasons, for example, there may be excess fat which is produced, or the fat which is produced in the body is not utilized by the body. Okay, there are some other reasons also for fatty changes in the liver. For example, if the person is obese, or if someone is having hypothyroidism, or in a female with condition of PCOD, or because of high cholesterol or triglyceride, these may be some of the very common reasons for which a person suffers from fatty liver. What are the symptoms? The person may feel lethargic, nauseatic at times, little pain in the upper right area where the liver lobe is there. So if there is some discomfort in that area, that is a symptom of fatty liver. How this fatty liver looks like, I'll show you a picture. Not a very beautiful picture, but definitely we should see. This is how a fatty liver looks like. Otherwise, it is maroonish in color. Healthy liver is maroonish in color. Okay, and this is how a fatty liver looks like. So see, you can see the two lobes very clearly and the fatty impregnation. This is fat deposition all over. And this was the natural color, which has darkened, which has become dark. So this is one condition in which we can use fat degeneration meridian for fatty changes in liver. Another condition in which we can use fat degeneration meridian is for heart. Okay, it is written fatty heart, fatty liver, fatty heart. That means if there is fat deposition in the heart, wall becomes more thick, then we call it fatty heart. So there is deposition of fat in the heart, and the area where this fat deposition is there, that layer is called myocardium. Myocardium. So in the myocardium, if there is fat deposition, we call it fatty heart. This is how it looks like. So that beautiful heart changes into fatty heart. Okay, so you can see fat accumulation everywhere. All this is nothing but fat. Third condition, which is mentioned in the book, is jawbone, fatty jawbone, isn't it? Fatty jaw bone. So for fatty jaw bone also, we can use this meridian. What is fatty jaw bone? Fatty jaw bone, the word itself is jaw bone. Jaw bone is upper bone, upper jaw and lower jaw. Upper jaw is, what is the name of the upper jaw bone? Maxilla. Lower bone is mandible. So maxilla, mandible. And fatty jaw bone means there's fat impregnation, fat deposition on the bone, on the jaw bone. Okay. So the condition the girl is looking beautiful, but there's fat deposition in this area. And those who have fat deposition in this area, they can make out very easily that there's fat in this area. Okay. So that is fatty jaw bone. Fourth condition which is mentioned here is fatty brain. See, why I'm showing this picture, because this is a very beautiful fact that brain is made up of 60% fat. Brain mein already 60% fat hai. Okay, then what is fatty brain? Fatty brain is a disease. It's a condition in which there is excess fat in the organ to function properly. That is fatty brain. Okay. Am I audible and visible?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, audio is muted, ma'am.
Am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, fat degeneration vessel meridian can be used to treat liver. It can be used to treat heart. It can be used to treat jaw bone. It can be used to treat brain. And it can also be used to treat kidney. We'll see how kidney can be used. Kidney can be treated through fat degeneration meridian. So, in the liver, if it is fatty liver. Heart, fatty heart. Jawbone, fatty jawbone. Brain, fatty brain. So these are the different organs where we can very clearly see that there is fat impregnation. Okay. Now, there are some tissue systems. There are some tissue areas where there can be fat accumulation. What are the different areas, tissue areas where there can be fat deposition? Tissues. See, there in the chapter itself, there are some terminologies mentioned. One is arterial sclerosis. Arterial sclerosis. In case of arterial sclerosis, we can use one more meridian. Many times we have discussed about it. Which meridian is that? AD meridian, allergy degeneration meridian. Okay, so we can choose allergy degeneration meridian to treat arterial sclerosis. Arterial sclerosis has one more name. What is that? Any idea? What is the other term for arterial sclerosis? Then note it down. It is also called a ATHERO, atherosclerosis, SCLEROSIS, atherosclerosis. Okay. And in many books written by Mata Prasadji Khemka, you will see it is written as Dhamani Kathinya. Don't get confused. What is that Dhamani Kathinya? Dhamani is your blood vessel. And Kathinya means kathin, hard. So hardening of the vessel. So wherever you get the protocol for Dhamani Kathinya means atherosclerosis or arterial sclerosis. Okay, so hardening of blood vessel can be treated through AD meridian and it can also be treated through fat degeneration meridian. So in case of arterial sclerosis, you will see that the vessel becomes hard. So it is written as atherosclerosis. It is same as arterial sclerosis. So you can see there is deposition. There's plaque formation here. Inside the blood vessel, and that is what is making it hard. It is losing its elasticity. Flexibility is not there, and that is one of the reason for high BP. So this is very commonly seen in heart disorders, heart ailments. So you will see that the blood vessel has some plaque formation, some depositions, deposition of different material, and it becomes hard. Because of that, blood pressure increases, heart has to pump more, it has to work more, and then gradually the heart diseases appear. Okay, so this is atherosclerosis or arteriosclerosis. This is one tissue disease in which we can treat, we can use fat degeneration vessel. Another fat degeneration, another disease in which we can use, and it is cerebral sclerosis. Cerebral sclerosis. What is this cerebral sclerosis? Now write down something about it. Huh? It is important to know that this is called SCHILDERS, Schilder's disease. DISEASE. Schilder's disease. What is this Schilder's disease? Schilder's disease, it is a disease that affects central nervous system. It's a rare disease and is equivalent to multiple sclerosis. Okay, and this disease, which is a rare disease of nervous system, usually starts in childhood or young adulthood. So this is cerebral sclerosis. Another disease which is mentioned is coronary vessel. It is written as coronary vessel and sclerosis. Just strike out "and." Okay, it's a misprint here. So make it coronary vessel sclerosis. Sclerosis, S-I-S. Coronary vessel sclerosis. So this name, the word itself suggests you what this disease is. Coronary vessel is a vessel of which organ? Coronary is related to heart. Okay, so coronary vessel is a vessel of heart. Sclerosis means hardening. That means the vessel which is supplying heart, it has become hard. That is called coronary vessel sclerosis. This coronary vessel sclerosis has, it also has another name, common name. So that is actually CAD. What is CAD? CAD is coronary artery, A-R-T-E-R-Y, coronary artery disease. It affects the arteries that supply the heart, and it is caused by arteriosclerosis. So arteriosclerosis means hardening of the blood vessel. So hardening of blood vessel, if it is there in coronary artery, we call it coronary vessel sclerosis. Okay. So the structure something becomes like this. So it's a normal, the first picture is of normal coronary artery and second is of artery where the plaque formation is. You can see the plaque formation, deposition. यहाँ पर कुछ deposition है. Because of that, यहाँ से जितना blood का flow होना चाहिए था, that is not happening 100%. So this is coronary artery disease or coronary sclerosis. The third, the fourth condition which is mentioned is lipoid nephrosis. Lipoid nephrosis. Now comes the condition of kidney. We, in the beginning only we mentioned about different organs where there may be fatty deposition. So kidney is mentioned here, lipoid nephrosis. So what is this lipoid nephrosis? Lipoid nephrosis also has another name. Actually, lipoid nephrosis is an old name. Now it is known as minimal, M-I-N-I-M-A-L, minimal change disease. Minimal change disease. What is minimal change disease? Minimal change disease is the name of the disease where kidney is affected. Kidney is affected where actually the glomerulus is affected. Glomerulus. Okay. What is glomerulus? In brief, I'll just tell you what glomerulus is because I'm explaining glomerulus. This is kidney. There are two kidneys, right? One right and one left. So there are two kidneys, two ureters, one urinary bladder. So this kidney is made up of very small structures, very small units, which are called nephron. like body is made up of cells, similarly kidney is made up of nephron. If I enlarge this nephron, the nephron looks something like this. There's a cup-shaped structure and there's a coiled structure after that, coiled tubes. And these coiled tubes gradually terminate into a collecting tubule. So there's a collecting tubule after that. Okay. On this cup-shaped structure, there's another structure which is present inside. There's a cup-shaped. In the cup-shaped structure, there's a tuft of ball. There's a tuft-like structure, which is called actually glomerulus. So this glomerulus is nothing but a part of nephron. And nephron is a unit of kidney. You got my point? So on the glomerulus, if there is fatty changes, so if there is some fat deposition here, then it is causing the disease, minimal change disease, or we also call it lipoid nephrosis, because it is related to nephron. This structure, this whole structure is nephron. Lipoid is related to the term lipid, fatty. So lipoid nephrosis. Now you may think about why we call it minimal change disease. We call it minimal change disease because this is a disease in which if you see this nephron, this glomerulus under microscope, normal microscope, you will not find any change. You will not be able to see detect the degenerative changes in the glomerulus. That is why we call it minimal change disease. This is visible only under electron microscope, very high power microscope. Okay. That is why it has been named as minimal change disease, also previously called lipoid nephrosis. So this lipoid nephrosis can also be treated through fat degeneration meridian. So what are the different tissue changes in which we can use fatty meridian? One was arterial sclerosis. Second one, cerebral sclerosis. Third one, coronary sclerosis. And fourth one, lipoid nephrosis. Okay. So these are the tissues in which there is impregnation, there is deposition of fat, and that is why we are using fatty meridian. So how to remember? Remember it as there are only two conditions in which we are using fatty meridian. What are the two conditions? Is fatty organs, and number two, sclerosis. Write down just these two words on top of the chapter or wherever you are making the notes. Wherever you get to see fatty changes, anywhere, any part of the body, whether it is in 1, 2, or 3, anywhere it is in the report that there are fatty changes, you can choose fatty meridian. Also, anywhere if it is mentioned, there is sclerotic changes. Sclerosis is there, whether it is in artery, maybe coronary artery, any normal artery, maybe in the cerebrum, maybe in the nephron, wherever it is, we can choose fatty meridian. So very simple to remember. Fatty changes in the organ or sclerotic changes in the tissues. Okay. Now see the meridian. Meridian is easier than this. Why? Because there are only 4 points. One of the smallest meridian, which has only 4 points. So what are these 4 points? Okay, I'll show you this picture also. This picture is about, see, this is nephron, glomerulus. Okay, this whole is nephron and a part of it is glomerulus. Fine. On the glomerulus, you can see the fatty changes. See, you can see the fat deposition, which is causing the problem of lipoid nephrosis. Okay. Before coming to the meridian, I can discuss a few more terminologies which I mentioned at the end of the chapter, and those are, see, at the end of this, before we are starting with the meridian, just before that, it is written lipomatosis. One. Number two, hyalinosis, H-Y-A-L-I. It's not written in the old book, huh? So refer to the new book. Hyalinosis. Number three, lipoidosis. Lipoidosis is in the next point, not in the same point. Lipoidosis. So understand these three points. Lipomatosis, hyalinosis, and lipoidosis. Lipomatosis. First, understand what is lipomatosis. Lipomatosis means excess fat in body. So what happens is, whenever we read a particular meridian, whenever we are understanding a particular chapter, every time we understand a point, we think about ourselves. Oh, this is the problem I am having. So, but this is not the problem which everyone faces with lipomatosis, excess fat in the body. Excess fat in the body here is a different ailment. It's a totally different ailment where what happens is, actually it has another name also. The other name for this disease is Medlung disease, M-A-D-E-L-U-N-G, Medlung disease. So what happens here is there's excess fat deposition in the upper thoracic, upper part of the body, in the neck, etc. So you can see lumps all over the body. So that is lipomatosis. I'll show you pictures. Hyalinosis. Hyalinosis is transformation of tissue. Tissue changes into homogeneous mass. What is the meaning of homogeneous mass? Homogeneous means of same nature. That means it has lost its characteristic nature. That is called hyalinosis. Lipoidosis is a condition in which there is disorder of fat. Fat metabolism. Leading to deposition of fat in organ. So wherever you get deposition of fat in a particular organ, we can call it lipoidosis. Like fatty liver. Fatty liver is an example of lipoidosis. So umbrella term is lipoidosis, under which we will get different organ fat deposition. Okay, so I'll show you the picture of lipomatosis. So this is a case of lipomatosis. You can see there is fat deposition everywhere. See, all these are lumps all over the upper part of the body. So this is your lipomatosis. Fine. Now come to the meridian. Fat D1, Fat D1B, Fat D2, and Fat D3. Only 4 points. So very simple to remember. 1, 2, 3, and a CMP. कितना भी पढ़ लीजिए, कितना भी difficult term समझ लीजिए, ultimately points तो चार ही use करने. तो क्या करना है? नीचे के लिए होगा तो 1, बीच के लिए होगा तो टू, ऊपर के लिए होगा तो थ्री, संग में सीएमपी। अब आप बोलोगे इतने सारे टर्म्स फिर क्यों पढ़ा दिए, इतने डिफिकल्ट डिफिकल्ट जिससे बदहजमी जैसी फीलिंग आ रही है। वी शुड नो दिस टर्मिनोलॉजी बिकॉज इफ अ पर्सन कम्स टू अस विद सम रिपोर्ट्स और सम फाइंडिंग्स वेयर दिस टर्म्स आर मेंशनड, वी शुड नॉट बी सरप्राइज्ड दैट व्हाट दिस टर्म इज। ओके, सो दीज टर्म्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड, सो राइट, जस्ट राइट डाउन समवेयर। बहुत बार ऐसे कॉल्स आते हैं और बहुत क्वेरीज आती हैं कि आप पढ़ाते हो, समझ में आता है, बहुत अच्छी से समझ में आता है, बट ये सब याद कैसे रहेगा? नहीं याद रखना है, लिख कर रखो। जब लिख कर रखेंगे, जरूरत पड़ेगी खोलेंगे तो समझ में आ जाएगा कि दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव अंडरस्टूड, वी नो दिस। ओके, सो फैट डी वन किसके लिए यूज होगा, व्हाट विल वी यूज इट फॉर? फैट डी वन ओनली लिवर, वी कैन यूज इट फॉर लेग्स, lower extremities, lower part of the body, so we can use it for legs, we can use it for hips, yeah, pelvis, we can use it for abdomen, and we can also use it for different organs in the abdomen below diaphragm, jitne bhi organs hai, liver, pancreas, spleen, kidney, wherever there is fatty impregnation. Second is fatty one B CMP. So CMP to pata hai, CMP is the prime minister. So we have to choose CMP wherever we are using fat degeneration vessel. So that is the most important point. Okay. Next is your fat D2. Fat D2 point will use above diaphragm, below the neck. So what will we use it for? We will use it for chest. Any degenerative changes in the chest, yes, and arm. So in the chest area, you have the heart, you have the vessels, major blood vessels. For those, we can use fat D2. Third one is fat D3. Fat D3 will use it for upper part. So upper part, you have the brain, yes. Face, in the face you have the jaw, specifically jaw is mentioned. So whenever you get a case where jaw area has more fat deposition, try to use it because specifically this is mentioned. Otherwise it would have been mentioned fat on the nose or fat on the eyes. No, it's not mentioned like this. It's specially mentioned fat in the jaw area. So in the jaw area we can use it, and also the brain, for the brain part, the the brain vessels. Brain vessels. So it was very simple, very, very interesting meridian where we understood that fat degeneration vessel is not only for body fat, but it is also for tissue fat and organ fat, lower part or organs, middle part or upper part, choose 1, 2, 3 along with CMP. Okay, now a very, very practical aspect to understand this fat D meridian is the location. Okay, the chapter was very simple, very easy to understand, but I'll show you something which is very important. So this is not a diagrammatic picture, this is actual picture of the foot where we are plotting the point. So to understand, this is also a very common question which many a times many therapists and learners ask, that how to understand the first joint, middle joint and lower joint on the toe. This is toe number one, this is toe two, this is toe three, this is 2-4, this is 2-5. So we are interested in this toe. Which side? Tibial side or fibular side? I know you know the side, but I want to know the name. Which side is this? This side is called tibial side. The other side is called fibular side. But this is a side where we have the tibial bone. So we call it tibial side. Now, how to locate the bone? this, you do one thing, you practice it on your foot. So you just bend your toe from the front part, from this part, and you will be able to make out that there is slight bony elevation here. If you bend your toe and you just feel it just below the nail, so you'll find one slight elevation here. Another elevation you will get, very clear elevation you will get here, very prominent one. This is the middle joint, okay, and the lowermost joint is this. It's a curvature, it's not a straight line. If you draw it like this, it is incorrect, because the bone is something like this. Here is a small bone, the second bone, and the third bone. See, when we are treating someone, we are not seeing the patient. Khemka sir hamesha bolte the ki when the patient is sitting in front of you, wo bhagwan hai, theek hai? Ab kya karna hai? Dr. Wall ne bol diya, bhagwan to hai, sang mein apni aankhon ke samne ek x-ray ki machine laga lo, aur samne baithe hue vyakti ko sharir bhi mat dekho, uske andar dhancha dekho. क्योंकि हमें तो बोन्स पर काम करना है. सो वी आर नॉट सीइंग द फुट, वी आर सीइंग द सो दी curvature is there. Wherever you get the bony curvature, that is the area you need to apply the seed or the magnet as required. You're getting my point? This is the area where you can apply seed, the methi seed. Here also you can apply methi seed. This is a very much practical thing which I'm telling you. So here you need to apply dry pea seed. Also, this is the area where we need to apply dry pea seed, because it has groove, bigger groove. So on the bigger grooves, you need to apply bigger seed. Okay, so this is all about fat degeneration. Ravindra sir,
even before I started the Sudharamesh and others have already mentioned that you are amazing.
Sir, Dr. Wall and Khemka sir and JP sir are amazing, so we are just learning.
Yeah, very nice, wonderful. So thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.